Melissa Carson's vice president and general manager of Iron Mountain. She sees several ways the sea services should attack sustainability.
Navy, for example, has engaged in what's called the Navy Sustainability Environmental Development Integration Program. So we can see they're quite serious about the whole environmental portion of it. And Iron Mountain sees it in a couple aspects. One is on the huge amount of hardware, IT assets. And with the development of technology, right, we're able to actually, you know, help them take the data off of all those assets and then recycle them. We only put about 5% of the IT assets into the landfill. So we break them down to the bare metals and plastics and all that. And then the classic Iron Mountain business, which is the record storage and the paper shredding. So with that, we put in the digitalization program, which is where we're taking their records and trying to securely, right, pull the data off of there for their mission critical applications. Help that, you know, kind of bridging from the paper world mm-hmm. to the digital world. But then from the sustainability aspect of it, because of our shredding business, we actually then could destroy all those documents, you know, properly. And then we put it back into the, you know, the economy as recycled paper.
Mm-hmm. What is the biggest obstacle that you've seen organizations in the military, even in the civilian space, have when it comes to making that transformation that you just talked about?
Two things is there are so many other priorities, you know, cybersecurity, the mission on the front line. So it's just really easy to kind of just shove it into a back room or a closet. It's only when those come and get overflowing, right, does it become a priority. So that's kind of the biggest challenge there. There's also the security aspect. I mean, everybody's, you know, very concerned about a cyber breach. And that's why, though, piling up in a closet isn't probably the right thing to do because there is still data on much of that. But as I said, it just doesn't take a priority over some of the, you know, the wartime and frontline pieces.
How much of the challenges that you just outlined, how much of those are technological and how much of those are cultural in the way the organization governs itself, the way that it stores stuff, those kinds of things?
It's probably more cultural than it is technology. Now, in some cases, the technology, when some of those assets were put into life, right, probably didn't get logged. So there's also a fear, right, of, oh, wait a minute, where do I even find the inventory tags or where were they? You know, system's been retired. So there's also kind of that traceability that we all know is extremely important. So a little bit of technology, but I think culturally they could probably figure out how to put those asset tags in. And once again, Iron Mountain's one of those ones that can take things that haven't been tagged and actually serialize them and make sure there's a, you know, a certificate of destruction to make sure that, as I said, at least there's that kind of end of life, tag on it.
Mm-hmm. When you see organizations that get themselves into trouble and have challenges, are there common threads among what those issues are that maybe doing things differently at the front end would help to ameliorate?
Yeah, I think so. There, one of the bigger challenges is people don't think anymore, right, that an innocent phone or even a really, really old laptop has data on it. Oh, okay, so they take the hard drive off and crush it. What we're finding is, though, particularly as the generations of technology has increased, and you're seeing here at the show, particularly with the Navy, is there's data on those chips also. So that's where we find some innocent person thinking, I've taken the hard drive out, I've destroyed it, I'm okay, but that's not true.
Mm-hmm. How can agencies address that up front and educate their people about the things that their people need to be aware of at the rank and file level and not just at the management the level of folks that are thinking about these enterprise-wide initiatives?
What we find is that very first, when you take it out of the box, as soon as you take it out of the box, log it someplace. So that's why we have a life cycle management system that takes it from right out of the box. Then there's the policies and then constant training for individuals. But we also follow, thank goodness, because of all those sensors, right, a simple scanner, your phone or whatever can keep track of the life cycle of that asset. So you could teach your people, right, and the servicemen and women, right, to actually take a picture of things and therefore track this asset throughout its life cycle that then's recorded in now this technology.